You are good, and I shall be just.
Stronger than the power of the wind.
These people have committed a great sin, yet now, if you would forgive their sin, and he stops. And there's this dash, weird in Scripture, strange verse. And all the commentators and all the translators, as we studied this, is that he didn't know what to do. He was getting a revelation, he was overwhelmed. He didn't know how to call it grace. But he was feeling something from God, and he said, God, I know they've messed up. Have you ever messed up? And I know that they don't deserve your love, but if you would forgive their sin, and then he just stopped. He didn't have the words to say what was in his mind, because there was no grace word at that time. He didn't know how to talk about it, but he was left speechless. He was overwhelmed to think of what he was daring to ask God. And he just paused. He didn't know what to say. He said, Lord, just blot me out of the book if you have to do it. But if you could forgive their sin, aren't you glad for the grace of God? He didn't know what it was, but we now call it the grace of God. That even though you're not worthy, God loves you anyway. That God knows everything terrible that you've ever done or even thought about, and yet he loves you, and yet he calls you his son, and he dares call you his daughter and his child. He gives you another chance, and he gives you a future. He blots out your past transgressions. Aren't you thankful today? You're here because of the grace of God. It ought to lead us all to understand what Moses was trying to say. He didn't have the words. He was left speechless. It took his breath away to think that God could do such a thing. Little did he know what was coming for us over here in this dispensation. That we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for the grace of God. Oh, I'm thankful today for the grace of God. I'm thankful that he included me when I didn't deserve it. Come on, somebody. He takes your breath away. And that's this next song that says, I'm speechless when I think about the grace. Think about what God's done for you. You should have been canceled out, but he included you because of his grace. Oh, it's amazing. Amen.
service to you, Lord. We just thank you and thank you that it's not over, God, that this is just starting, Lord. We just thank you for everything that we've been through to get to this point, God. You've used every single thing that's happened to us, God, to get us where we're at, to get us to where we're headed, God. We just thank you for today. We dedicate this service to you, God. We just thank you for these 19 years we've had, God. We give you the glory and dedicate the next ones to you, Lord. We thank you for this service. I pray that you just bless this church, God, beyond anything we can even imagine, God. We just thank you. We want to be speechless, God. We thank you. We give you all the glory and the honor. It's in your precious name that we pray today. Amen.
Come on, you can give the Lord a better hand clap than that. We've been standing a while now, and it's wonderful to worship God, isn't it? Now, we want you to know you're the friendliest church in town, and the people here love you, accept you just the way you are, just like God does, but he loves you too much to keep you that way. We're all in the process of changing. Turn to your neighbor and look around, and if you haven't seen somebody in a while, or just getting acquainted, would you put your hand in theirs, hug their neck, and welcome them to the house of God today. Just be friendly, and happy anniversary to each one of you. God bless every single one of you.